citadel. And once again, here you can see the columns from a previous culture, a previous temple, a previous structure being used as parts of the wall again. And there's some remaining portions of the temple. And we were noticing in the backside and right here too, there's some narrow gauge tracks right there going all the way. Who knows what the hell it was? Transportation or what? So this is the mock of the castle, or the citadel they call it. And that's the entrance right there, of course. And I'm pointing out some ancient structures here, a bunch of columns and other stuff. And here's the narrow gauge tracks also going all the way out. What was it? Transportation for people, you know, one of those Ducaville French trains, who the fuck knows. And I want to point out also the reusing of sections of temples and stuff like that. There's an archer's position right here, and another one on top, and there's even this fucking chest. Kill the motherfuckers. And, you know, there's archer's position, the column, and the city surrounding the kill this motherfucking chest. I read that the dungeon in this castle is the tallest dungeon dating back to this time. Can you come up, madre? Looking at this shit from an engineering point of view. There you go. Best example. Right there, you got the arch and then the dissipation of the weight to the sides, and that shit taking it all the way down. So there's the citadel. There's the tracks I was mentioning earlier. Let's see if we can do this trick. Anyways, there's some tracks there. Signs of a war from who knows when. So we're getting out of the castle, and here it is. Amazing. You can find that shit for $501,000. Look a little bit down to the edge of the water. This place is my friends. There's the Agora right there. There. And this is one of the sarcophagi guy, and there's another one right there. I don't mean to go, who the fuck knows. But there's the folks, the hole where those burials were. And you can see that there's this structure for a roof right there, or a cover for the burial place. And that's one of the sarcophagi guy from this hole maybe, and another one. They're intact. They're not like the ones a couple days ago. Well, never mind. There's the floor. There's the floor. It's turning into a recycled bin for fucking bottled water. There's another burial place over there. There's another sarcophagus. Sarcophagus there. Bunch of columns. Bunch of holes. They were digging this pit out. It's another hole. I guess they were looking for graves from volcanoes or ravines or whatever. And they found some holes, sarcophagi, and they did not find any others. So there's the Agora right there. And we're gonna walk towards. I don't have a lot of time. I don't wanna be here all day. The sun is burning horrendously, and no. There's houses, so there's pieces of shit everywhere, buildings, and there's sarcophagi everywhere. And they left them right next to the place they found them. Like in this case, that hole right there, and then they stand all around so stupid people would not fall in and kill themselves. And this is the Roman Agora. Those sarcophagi, by the way, are Roman. Yeah, this is the Roman place, you know, dating back the Crusades, obviously. And there's the Agora right here. The little Agora, I mean, there was a big wall up here, I believe. And somewhere in here, there was a wall, and it was for the Memphis. Trying to make it to the port. The port is down there. I don't think it's original, but it's been continuously used. And this port was used way back to the 10th century BC. The trading here dates back to the Silk Road, you know, to the beginning, 2,000 years ago, and so on. And trade. This was part of the end of the Silk Road trade of lapis lazuli, was done with Afghanistan, among other places. So now both places are in trouble. Anyways, I'm out of here.